on this time.
I
somebody asked you, some of them out here are SD38s, they have a smaller fuel tank in there, so that's why, you know, different number. They also had a different engine, one had a 645, 16 cylinder, the other had a 645 12 cylinder. One is turbocharged, one is unusable. They're not all unusable, there's a blower in there instead of a turbocharger.
That's me, I never knew that.
So the 598 has a unusable engine, and the way you can tell, there's stacks on the top, there's only stacks out there, on the top of it. Other you.
I got good vision, but my vision ain't that good.
They're right above the P and right above the I in Union Pacific, on the top.
All the two little things sticking up?
Oh, your exhaust stacks.
Or like the 7122, that's the back, which is on the back there.
That's for the turbocharger.
Okay.
But that's an exhaust, the turbocharger, the other two are for the blower, that's it.
Okay.
The blower, it's not the engine.
That was like a supercharger versus turbo.
Now that I understand, because I go to the first.
So, these are probably the locomotives for four or five different trains. So we're gonna move them all at one time, then we're gonna separate them and tell you, well, your locomotive's gonna be that fancy one number, UP1995, and whatever is hooked to that. So, and that's because the different locomotives have different horsepower. Chicago, Los Angeles, Chicago, we're sorting the freight cars based on the destination where they're going to.
Okay.
We'll get a train in here of about 150 cars, there's one across the yard, they see that yellow car rolling all by itself?
Yeah.
So we're sorting that train, the fellow in the tower is giving him a number, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's why you see 3, here comes, he gave him the number 5 now, because there's 5 cars coming down.
Yeah, okay.
So we told him all 5 of those cars are going to a place, and the guy on the ground that's uncoupling cares not where they're going to, just give me a number.
Uh-huh.
Because he's also running the two locomotives that are probably a mile and a half out over there. He's running it with a remote control handle. Okay, here comes your car coming down the train. So I want it to come down the hill, and I want it to go over there. So I got to throw a switch here, I got to throw this one over there, throw this one over here. Somebody would have had to do this. It would have taken about a minute and a half for that one car to get down over there.
Okay.
Now it's taking 20 seconds because the computer is ready to throw all those things working on the next couple of minutes.